the damn thing went off. And it was a rather awesome sight.
For Ted Hall, the Cold War had begun the year before.
I decided to give atomic secrets to the Russians because it seemed to me that it was important that there should be no monopoly which could turn one nation into a menace and turn it loose on the world as Nazi Germany developed. There seemed to be only one answer to what one should do. The right thing to do was to act to break the American monopoly.
Others thought the same way. The KGB had several sources inside Los Alamos, unknown to one another. The scientist Klaus Fuchs. cards back to the drawing board. The Korean War provided further blows to the CIA's self-confidence, highlighting gaps in forecasting and assessment.
The CIA was wrong about the start of the war. They were wrong about the Chinese involvement and intervention in the war, and they were wrong about the capabilities of the North.
Crisscrossed beneath the city. To intercept them, the Americans and British drove a tunnel deep into the Soviet sector.
The purpose of the Berlin Tunnel was to tap the communications lines of the Soviet forces in East Germany, in Poland, and their links with Moscow, in order to provide current intelligence on those forces and also early warning.
In answer to the president's question, how long can they fire these missiles, I relied primarily on the combination of intelligence sources, but mainly Penkovsky's information, which told us how these missiles operated in the field.
The CIA assessment is said to have bought the president 3 precious days' breathing space. Ironically, Penkovsky himself was now under KGB surveillance. The last time Joe Bulik had seen him was in Paris.
I never had the feeling that he was in danger, otherwise I would have insisted that he stay. In fact, forced him if I had to kidnap him. But I never really had the feeling that he was, at that time, at our last meeting in Paris, I never felt that he was in danger.
Back in Moscow, Penkovsky sent what seemed like a routine message.
We'd gotten a signal from Penkovsky that a dead drop was loaded. And when we sent Dick Jacobs to service that dead drop, he was arrested. And as soon as that happened, we knew the case was over. He was dead. And then Penkovsky was in the hands of the KGB. Punkt.
Расскажите о начале вашей преступной деятельности. В ноябре 1960 года я решил войти в контакт с американской разведкой. Для чего я подготовил письмо, в котором высказал эту свою просьбу и желание начать со мной работу.
The chief KGB interrogator was Alexander Zagvozdin.
We questioned him not once, not 10 or 20 times, but perhaps 100 times. He realized that his actions were punishable by death. And he used to ask me, will I be executed? I never said he wouldn't. I never said he wouldn't be executed. I used to say one thing. Only if you confess everything and repent fully can you hope for mercy. That's probably why Penkovsky's life was not spared. He didn't confess everything. I know for sure that Penkovsky was shot. I can't tell you anything else. I know his body was cremated. I don't know any more. And I'm not interested.
Kim Philby is buried with full honors in a Moscow cemetery. He first betrayed Britain half a century before, passing a wealth of secrets to the KGB. And yet converts were never wholly trusted. To the end, the KGB opened his mail and bugged his phone. It seemed as if the age of the spy was over. 1894, Ames was arrested for spying, along with his wife Rosario, after years of high living.
Shock, depression, instant recognition of, you know, one's life flashes before one. A sense of things coming to an end, but no sense of. Gave up names. They gave up secrets. I did the same thing. For reasons that I considered sufficient to myself, I gave up the names of some of the same people who had earlier given up others. It's a nasty kind of circle. With terrible human costs.
Aldrich Ames is serving a life sentence with no remission. Dmitry Polyakov was sentenced to death. He was executed in 1988 with a bullet in the back of the head.